When it comes to SEO, do you know what keywords your competitors are indexing for that you aren't? There's a website that does. I'm Olivia with Whole Whale, and today we're going to do a walkthrough of the content gap feature on Ahrefs. Okay, but what is Ahrefs, apart from a mouthful to say? It is a data-driven SEO tool that allows you to track things like backlinks, organic traffic, indexing keywords, and non-indexing keywords. You can sample it for 7 days for $7, and from there, the fees start at $99 a month for a subscription. And in this 7-day trial, one of the first things you should play around with is the content gap. This is a tool that tells you what keywords other websites index for that your site does not. You can try this against competitors. You can try it against sites that you're interested in being more like. You can even try it against wholewhale.com and see what happens.
So once we've logged into Ahrefs, we can enter in any domain in the upper search bar. Let's go with Whole Whale. And once we get onto the overview page, we can go into the left-hand menu and click on Content Gap. We'll see that our website, wholewhale.com, has already populated at the bottom. And then we can add any number of websites up top that we want to check against for keyword gaps. So let's enter in ssir.org, which is the Stanford Social Innovation Review, a Whole Whale client and one of our favorite publications when it comes to the social impact space. And we can click Show Keywords here to get a sense of how we stack up against one another. Now, by default, this list will focus on the United States. It will give us a sense and sort automatically by volume, the monthly search volume of any given keyword. It will also look at the difficulty, which is how hard it would be to break into the top 10 Google search results for a keyword. And then we can also sort by cost per click, which is an estimate of how much it would cost to rank for that given keyword and get click-throughs on it. We also get a sense of how these keywords look in search engine results pages. And we can also see the highest position that SSIR.org has achieved for each of these keywords, as well as how they look in search indexing, because of course it is way more than just landing in the top 10 search results. We can also change the sorting. So for instance, I've just clicked on the volume to sort from the lowest number of searches per month up to the highest, if we want to get a sense of what some of the maybe dark horses are in this competitive keyword gap. And we can export, but first, exporting will only give you the first 50 lines, so you want to make sure that you're probably getting the more valuable keywords. We can export this for Excel, OpenOffice. We generally just default to Excel. And the reason that we focus on one website at a time is because since we only get 50 keywords, it's very easy for any number of websites to compete against one another and still only get really data for one website. So generally, we tend to look at it one at a time. But for instance, let's look at how the Nonprofit Times and the Chronicle of Philanthropy in conjunction with SSIR stack up against Whole Whale, just so you can sort of see how we would do this with more than one website at a time. So once the keywords have sorted here, for instance, we see that there actually is a fairly good balance between the Chronicle of Philanthropy and SSIR, but Nonprofit Times is getting a little lost in the mix here. We're also starting to see more branded keywords come in, so these are obviously less important for us as Whole Whale to rank for. We may also see keywords like wicked problems up here, which, you know, being a New England native, I should have a soft spot for that, but probably in terms of Whole Whale's overall content strategy, not important. Once again, we click export and we can start that export. And then open it up. We like to open it up in Google Drive so that we can share these sheets internally as a team. So we'll just open that and then open with Google Sheets. And once you export these CSVs from ahrefs.com, you'll see that they give you the keyword volume description, keyword difficulty, cost per click. And if you are, whether you're using one or multiple domains, they'll give you that domain so you can track. We like to delete the ranking column right away. And then also under data sort, enable the first row for sorting so that we can sort by difficulty if we want. We could also sort by cost per click, volume, or even if we have multiple domains, sort by those rankings as well, just to see what some of the top keywords are for, say, SSIR, the Chronicle of Philanthropy, and the Nonprofit Times. We can also go through and start to delete some of the keywords that we don't find as relevant for us. And then we could take these keywords, and what we like to do actually is enter them into a keyword tool on Moz to get a deeper sense of what to prioritize first.
And then comes the million-dollar question, what do we do with all of these insights? The big picture with Ahrefs is to take a look at the keywords and start to make prioritization. You may look at some of these keywords and say, but wait a second, we have a page that is written around this exact keyword. What gives? Why aren't we indexing for it? That's a good chance to go back to the content you already have and see how you can optimize it against best practices of writing for the robots of Google while engaging the humans using Google. You can also start to prioritize new content pieces around keywords that you have no content for and should be considering. And then there are going to be some keywords, like branded keywords or keywords for a topic completely tangential to what you cover, that you can just ignore. These are just prescriptive, data-driven suggestions coming out from a very robotic function on a website. These are not the do these 10 articles and you will start to reach SEO nirvana. This is just information that we take. We glean insights from the information, we learn and act, and we measure from there. I'm Olivia with Whole Whale, and if you want to take your SEO game one step deeper, we have a full course for that. You can check it out at Whole Whale University, wholewhale.com/university. It's hosted by myself and our chief whaler, George Weiner. We may even have a cameo from our French bulldog turtle in there. And you can access it at a special discount using the code WWVideo. Be sure to comment below to let us know what other functions of Ahrefs you want us to cover next. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Help us with our own YouTube SEO.